Hi, people. This is Charles Butler, host of The Reality Check with Charles Butler on Genesis Communication Network, airing Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. Eastern Time. And you can get us at www.gcnlive.com, or you can pick us up on some terrestrial stations around the country. So you'd have to go to the website to find out what those are. They change all the time. I want to talk this morning a little bit about Veterans Day. Happy Veterans Day to all you vets. Thank you for serving. Love you. Hope that things are going well for you. And we have a man in the White House now who really cares about vets and is not going to talk about how great vets are and how we need to help our vets on one hand and then go and take funding back on the other. That's what Barack Obama has done. That's what he continues to do. He continues to allow incompetent people to have positions in the VA and say, well, you know, if we fire them, we'll ruin their careers. Their careers need to be ruined. We need to get back to common sense approaches to governing and conducting these government organizations in an effective and efficient manner. The show today, we had Fari Hamzi on with us, the founder of Hamzi Analytics, and we talked about how the markets responded after Brexit and also after the election and before the election of Donald Trump. The markets were supposed to be up on Tuesday morning because Hillary Clinton was being elected, and they were optimistic. Well, the same thing happened with Brexit because they thought the Brits were going to stay in the EU. Surprise, 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 as Gomer Powell would say. The markets are up, the markets crashed for a minute, and they came right back. Same thing with Brexit. You know, people get over it. You know, the bottom line is the people voted the way that they wanted to vote, both in the UK and here in America. And they voted to take control of their government, take control of their lives, and enhance their lives instead of those in China, India, Mexico, and other underdeveloped countries. We also had George Watson on. George is the current airport manager out of Ramona Airport in California, flies a T-34 Mentor. He and other Mentor flyers or pilots are piloting these aircraft around California doing Veteran Day ceremonies. By the way, happy Veterans Day to you veterans out there. Thank you for serving. I think I said that before, but I'll say it again. I'll make another comment before we leave today. We also had, George commented on the anarchists who were out there protesting Mr. Trump, and he said, we need to deal with them. We need to meet them head on. We need to meet violence with violence. I agree wholeheartedly. We had Dr. Bonner Cohen with us from the National Center for Public Policy Research, and we talked about the election, the effects of the election, and where we are today. Great conversation. Also, we had Mr. Doug Giles on, who wrote a book called Pacification of the American Male. I could have helped him to write that book because I talk about that all the time, how, you know, American men have constantly been emasculated, or people are trying to emasculate them, whether it's their spouse or others. But we need to stand up and start being a strong country again, male-oriented, and push forward. That's not to the exclusion of women, but to certainly say, if you want to play in the kitchen, this is the kitchen we're going to have, not a bunch of girly girls like Dianne Feinstein wants to have in the Senate. She's totally pathetic. I hate Dianne Feinstein. Anyway, but check out Doug's book, Doug Giles, G-I-L-L-S. He has a site called, I think it's called Clash Daily, clashdaily.com. The two most powerful men, or soon to be most powerful men, in America met yesterday. President Obama and President-elect Donald Trump. Now, just last Monday, President Obama was calling Donald Trump a racist, a misogynist. He's the most dangerous man in the world. He couldn't be. He's unfit for office. And now he has to sit in the same room with him and shake hands with him. You know, I think this hurt Barack Obama more than meeting with Putin. And because he actually thought that the American people really went along with his programs, really went along with his whole agenda. We rejected his agenda on Tuesday, and we showed him that, yes, your legacy will be destroyed because Donald Trump has run on everything that Obama put in place, whether it's the Obamacare, the trade agreements like TTP, treaty with Iran on the nuclear deal. We got to pull all that stuff. Selling Russia 20% of our uranium stockpile. We're going to get rid of all of these things. We're going to put the warrior culture back in the military. You know, these are things that need to be done, and they need to be done ASAP. Not yesterday. They need to be done today. They need to get done. And Donald Trump is the kind of guy that will get those things done. He's a doer. The election has consequences. Mr. Obama said that himself. Elections have consequences. Well, guess what, Obama? They do, and we're glad that you said that so that we can let you know that, yes, elections have consequences, and your whole legacy will be unraveled here very shortly, and I hope very quickly. Protesters. These are professional anarchists. They need to be put down. They're not protesters. They're not peaceful protesters. They're carrying baseball bats, intimidating people. And yesterday here in Chicago, we have on tape where two black men beat this white guy because he was a Trump supporter. I wish they had jumped on me because I need to let out a little aggression these days. And I'd like to help them out a little bit. But they jumped on this poor white guy and beat him down. I hope they're caught. I hope they're incarcerated. And I hope they do time. That's what I hope. Well, I try to keep these little vignettes around 5 minutes. We're running a little over today, but that's okay. It's Veterans Day, and I want to say again, happy Veterans Day to you all that served, and we'll be back again on Monday, Mindset Monday, so tune in the show, 8 to 10 Eastern Time, 8 to 10 a.m. Eastern Time, okay?